Hey everybody, Varun here from Language Academy. Guys, very excited to connect with all of you once again. This video is going to be about your listening section and in particular about listening fill in the blanks. One of the section or tasks we actually underestimate, a lot of students do think that that's not very important. It's not that important to practice, it's fine, it will be fine, it's not that difficult. We have to just listen to an audio and write down whatever the speaker says. But guys, believe me, this can be a difficult one if you do not really practice or if you're not really prepared for the uncertainties. This task can be a difficult one. So in this video, this will be a quick video, a short video. I'll be sharing all the strategies, all the tips and all the things you need to keep in mind when you are doing listening fill in the blanks. Guys, first of all, what happens in this task, you'll have a transcript on your screen and an audio or a lecture will be played for the same transcript. So the speaker will say each and every thing same as you'll have the transcript on your screen, but there will be few words missing in the transcript which you have to listen, note them down and type them back so that you can be awarded score for that. Now why this task is very very important, because this is going to give you around 10 to 12 points in your listening and 10 to 12 points in your writing section as well. If you are struggling in your listening section and writing section, and if you're taking your listening blanks very easy, make sure you practice these, see how many you're getting right and how many you're getting wrong. And this can be one of the big reasons why you're not getting your scores in listening and writing section. Alright, what are the things you need to be careful about? Very first thing, you'll have the transcript on your screen. You're getting 1 point for each correct blank. Now, when we say each correct blank, it doesn't really mean that you have heard it right and you have typed whatever you wanted to or whatever you think it was. To get 1 point out of one, you have to make sure your spellings are correct. Along with the spellings, you need to make sure that if the requirement of the blank is that you need to capitalize the word, you have to capitalize it. For example, let's say there was a blank or there is a blank just after the full stop. Make sure whenever you are typing the word, you have to capitalize the first word, first alphabet I mean. If you do not capitalize the first alphabet, you are going to lose a lot of points for that. Right, so any blank after, straight after the full stop, make sure you have to start it with a capital alphabet. To get 1 point out of one, your spelling should be 110% correct. Especially make sure if there's any S at the end of the word or any ED at the end of the word. For example, there's a word called Indians, right, with S. So make sure you put a S over there, otherwise you are going to lose points for that. For example, there's a word called played, P-L-A-Y-E-D. If you just write play or if you just write plays, you're going to lose points for that as well. Another thing, be very careful about proper nouns. Let's say there's any proper noun such as name of a place, person, any organization, any religion, any language. Doesn't matter what the case is, if it's the first word of the sentence or it's somewhere towards the end of the sentence, you have to make sure all the proper nouns you always start with a capital alphabet. If you do not start with a capital alphabet, you are going to lose points for that as well. Another thing, guys, there are two styles of writing English or English, you can say. One is UK and another one is US. We call them UK style and US style. What's the difference? The difference is between the spellings. Most of the time, whenever you write UK style, you always use the word S, and in US you use the word Z. So make sure in each and every task you only follow one style. Let's say you're following UK style, you have to make sure you write all the blanks in UK English or UK format. For example, let's say there are two blanks, one is organizing and the other one is analyzing. You cannot write organizing with Z and analyzing with S. Either you write both with Z or both with S. You have to only follow one style, and that is how you are going to get score. One very, very important thing, last thing which I'll tell you, make sure whenever the audio is going on, do not, that's what I always recommend all my students, do not straight away type the answer into the keyboard. What you need to do, make sure you use the notepad and the pen provided over there. Make the notes of all the blanks, first write them down, and while writing them down, a lot of students, what they do is, let's say they have got the first blank or they have figured out what the first blank is, they move their eyes from the screen and they start looking into the notebook and then they take the notes. By the time they take the notes and they look back on the screen, they miss the flow of the whole passage, and while they try to figure out where the passage is, the passage is gone and you miss a lot of blanks. So what you need to figure out, or what you need to take care, you need to take care of this, that you always keep your eyes on the screen and keep your hands moving so that you can write them down. Also, whenever you write your blanks or fill the blanks or write them in the notepad, make sure you always write them in a vertical manner, not in a horizontal manner. A lot of time what happens, what may, can happen in the exam when listening audios are very fast, you might miss one or two blanks, right? And if you're writing them horizontally, you won't be sure that which one is the answer for the first blank, which one is the answer for the second blank, which one is the answer for third blank, and so on. So you can mess up the sequence and that can create a lot of problem. So always keep your eyes on the screen while the audio is going on. Keep your hands moving. Another thing, make sure you write them vertically, not horizontally. Otherwise, you can create a few problems for yourself. So that's it, guys. These were a few of the tips for your listening fill in the blanks. I hope you got a bit of information regarding this task. If you want to practice listening fill in the blanks, you can go onto a website www.languageacademy.com.au. There's a lot of practice material which is going to help you to crack your exam. All the very best, guys. If you have any doubts, please leave them down in the comment section. I'll try to answer them. If you're struggling to pass your exam, you can contact us. Or if you want me to make any other video, please leave down your preferred topic or whatever you want me to make a video on, and I'll try my best to help you in each and every possible way. Thanks a lot, guys. Stay connected. Make sure you subscribe. Thank you very much. I'll see you very soon.